Hi everyone, my name is Dr. Chinnan Sirosat, and again today I will be presenting you the time value of money. The TVM concept is the major concept that shape the finance theory. We will learn how to use it at this chapter. So after studying this chapter, you will understand the concept of future value, right? With both annual and intra-year compounding. So when you talk about future value, you need to compound it. Okay, we think about future, and you will be able to distinguish between future value and present value. And you also know how to calculate both future value and present value. you will be able to calculate the future value and present value, of course, right, of single payment, single sum, or annuity. What is annuity? The fixed or the sequence of the fixed amount payment, okay, for a given period of time. And you will see how to utilize your future value and present value table. So this one is how to calculate the present value and future value by using what we call time value of money or TVM tables. So it will concern two principles. After chapter one that we talk about. Principle one, money has a time value, right? So $1 today is worth more than $1 tomorrow. We will learn why. And principle three, cash flow are the source of value. Only cash that can earn interest, not accounting profit. In order to do your job, as we know, right, we have three major tasks that finance manager need to do to maximize wealth. But before we know the concept of finance, the TVOM or time value of money is the major principle that shape all the finance theory. So you have to know the concept of TVOM. Okay, if we know that receiving $1 today, okay, is worth more than $1 in the future. Why? Because you have opportunity to take that $1 today to invest it. To invest it and get more money in the future. So that reflect what? Interest, right? So interest rate, or we can call it opportunity cost, the same thing. So interest rate will be equals to real risk free rate, okay? Real risk free rate plus expected inflation plus risk premium. Risk free rate, real risk free rate plus inflation, we call nominal risk free rate. And then plus risk premium, so you get interest rate. So $1 today is worth more than $1 tomorrow because of you can compound interest and you can get more money in the future. Okay, so here is the explanation of the component of interest rate. The first one is real risk free rate. How do you measure real risk free rate? Let's say you hungry today. You hungry now. You want to eat now, right? If someone comes to you and say, can you eat tomorrow? Now you may say yes, but you have to compensate me with something, right? So that real risk free rate can represent what? The postpone of your consumption. Economically, you can use the real GDP growth rate as real risk free rate. Plus what? Plus second item is expected inflation rate, okay? If inflation is expected to be 10%, you are not going to lend someone the money lower than 10%, right? Why? If you lend someone money and charge them only 3% and inflation is 10%, so you will have like what? At least negative 7% return, because the value of money will be lower, right? In case of inflation. Plus, the last one is uncertainty. Or risk premium. What is risk one more time? Risk is uncertainty of what you expect. Whatever you expect from your investment is maybe it has uncertain. If you lend someone that has the good credit history, the risk premium should be low, right? Should be low compared to if you lend someone and that one is a bad guy, you know, never pay money on time with full amount, maybe you might have to charge him or her more risk premium. Okay, so three components together cause interest rate. And then we also need to know the concept of timeline. Okay, timeline identify the timing and amount of stream of the cash flow along with interest rate. So the timeline can be any unit, right? Can be any unit. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, as you can see. So you see at time zero means now, okay? -100 means cash outflow, cash out of your pocket, $100. You see number one, right? Number one is mean at that $30 is happening at the end of period one. $20 happening at the end of period two. -10, I mean cash outflow is happening at the end of period three. And last one, $50 is happening at the end of period four. And this timeline interest rate is 10% per period. So this period can be any unit, any time, like year, like month, like days, like hour, like seconds. So and it can be anything. And interest rate need to follow the time unit. If the number if the timeline is year, so interest rate need to be per year. But if the timeline is per month, interest rate need to be per month. All right. So we will talk about the concept of compounding and discounting of single sum. Okay. If we can measure this opportunity cost or interest rate, we can translate one dollar today into its equivalent in the future. We talk about compounding. Okay, how much do we have at the future, in the future, right? So if you translate one dollar in the future into its equivalent today, so we talk about backward, right? So we need to discount the future money into its equivalent now. So when you compound or discount interest rate, there are two concepts to deal with interest. Number one is simple interest. Simple interest is interest is earned only on the principal amount. Compound interest is interest is that earned on both the principal and accumulated interest for the previous period. Okay. Example, suppose that you deposit $500 in your saving account that earns 5% annual interest, how much will you have in your account after 2 years? Using A, simple interest, and B, compound interest. Simple interest means you you earn interest based on principal only. So interest earned equals to 5% of $500 or $25 per year. And then total interest earned will be what? Total interest 2 years. So take 2 multiplied by $25 equals to $50. So at the end of year 2, you will have what? Principal $500 plus accumulated interest 50. So you get what? $550. What about compound interest? Interest is not only calculated from principal but accumulated interest as well. So interest earned in year 1, at the end of year 1 will be 5% of $500 or $25. Interest earned in year 2 will be 5% of $500 plus accumulated interest, which is what, $25, right, from year 1. So interest earned in year 2 will be what, 5% of $525 or $26.25. So at the end of year 2, you will get what? The total money will be principal $500 plus interest at the end of year 1, $25, and interest at the end of year 2, $26.25, which is higher than $25. Why? Accumulated interest. So at the end of the day, you will have what, $551.25, which is higher than the previous scenario, simple interest, $550. Okay? So let's talk about future value. Okay? Future value of single sum. If you deposit $100 in an account earning 6%, how much would you have at the end of year 1? So first of all, you draw the timeline. Okay, you draw the timeline. Zero means now, one means at the end of year one. PV means present value, FV means future value. So if you put $100 today, negative means cash outflow. Okay. If you use there are three ways to get to the answer. The first way is to use the financial calculator. Okay. Not regular ones. Financial calculator. Your job is to put the function p slash y. This is compounding period equals to one now. I 6%. N equals to one compounding period. P slash y. I'm sorry. Is how many compounding period per period. Okay. How many times that you compound per period. N equal to one. Okay. Compounding period. PV negative 100. In your financial calculator, you need to put the negative sign. So that they will know what this is, cash outflow, and then press calculate. You will get FV 106. It's your future value of single sum 100. The second way that you can get to the answer is to use what we call TVUM table. Okay, by using FV equals to PV. You know PV 100, right? Multiply by FVIF. This is a table for future value for single sum. Given I and N, how many percent and how many compounding period. So we will go to find that number FVIF in the table. Okay, so you look at the table. Here is the table. Okay, so you see 6%, N equals to 1. As you can see, it will be equals to what, 1.06, right? So FVIF given 6% N 1, you will get 1.06. You take 1.06, multiply it by 100, right? So PV is 100. So the answer will be 106. Or the third way that you can get to the answer is to use the formula. FV equals to PV multiply by 1 plus I, right? I is interest rate, power by N. So why we use multiply, not divide? Because FV value is greater than PV value, right? So you take I, 6%, don't forget to make decimal. So 1 plus 0.06 power by 1, right? N is equal to 1. So the answer is 106, okay? Same answer. Let's change n from 1 year to 5 years. So what should be your new answer? Change n from 1 to be 5. You deposit the same $100, okay? But now just change n from 1 to be 5. What happened to FV? Use your calculator. You change n from 1 to be 5, you get what? 133.82. 133.82. Use the TVUM table. So you have to use what? FV equals to PV multiplied by FVIF given I and N. So I is 6%, N now not 1, is 5, right? So you look at the table, you get what? FVIF given 6% N 5, you get 1.3382. You take 1.3382 multiplied by 100, you get the same answer. Or use the formula. The last one is formula, okay? FV equals to PV multiplied by 1 plus I power by N. So N is 5 now. So FV will be the same, 133.82. Now, if you deposit the same $100 in account, earn 6% with now quarterly compounding. Quarterly means what? 1 year you have how many quarters? 4 quarters, okay? How much would you have in the account after 5 years? So 5 years equals to how many quarters? 20 quarters, yes or no? 5 multiplied by 4 equals to 20 quarters. So your timeline unit is quarter now. Can we use 6% as interest rate? No. You need to transform 6% per year to be per quarter. So you take 6% divided by 4. You get what? 1.5%. Per quarter. You see, n change from 5 to be 20 because per quarter. You put the same money, use your calculator, you see p slash y from 1 to be 4, right? Because you compound 4 times per year. I the same 6% N20 PV negative 100. So you get FV 134.68, which is greater than the previous answer 133. Remember 133 point something. Why? Because more compounding period. Okay. Ah, you can use also the table, right? TOM table. Find FVIF 1.5% N20. Okay, but your table might not have like it need to be integer for the number. So maybe you use the formula. Okay, use the formula FV equals to PV multiplied by 1 plus I, right? But I right here, you need to divide by M because M is compounding period. So M in this case equals to 4, right? I 6% divided by 4, you get 1.5%. Power by M multiplied by N. M is what? 5 years, N 4, right? So 20. I'm sorry. M is 4, right? 4 times a year. N 5 years. So M multiplied by N equals to 20. You get the same answer. Now, let's change from quarterly compounding to be monthly compounding. So monthly compounding means, 12 times a year, right? So you need to change N, okay? From what? From 5 years to be what? 60, right? So that one is not 20, it's supposed to be 60. So 12 is M, N is 5, so 12 multiplied by 5 equals to 60, okay? Not 20, 60. You put the same money, 100, use calculator, you see you change P slash Y from 4 to be 12, because monthly compounding I equal to 6%, N 60, you see N 60, PV negative 100, so you get FV 134.89, right, which is greater than the previous case, why more compounding period. Use the table, FV equals to PV, FVIF given I and N, so can we use the table? Actually, no, why? The number is too many, right? It's 60, we don't have it on the table, so you can use the formula. FV equals to PV multiplied by 1 plus I. I right here is what? How many percent? 6%, but you need to divide it by 12, right? By 12, because monthly compounding. And N need to be 60. Right, it need to be 60, so you get the same answer, 134.89. What about continuous compounding? This is a maximum compounding period that the lender can charge. What is the FV of $1,000 earning 8% with continuous compounding after 100 years? So we have the formula, okay? The formula for continuous compounding, FV equals to PV multiplied by E power by IN, okay? So E is equal to 2.7 something. So FV then will be equal to PV 1000 E power by I 8%, right? Make decimal multiply by number of years 100. So that you get 2,980,000 something, right, as your answer, okay?